I know that it seems sometimes that no matter what you do, and no matter how hard you work, striving to make things better in your life, but for some reason you're not getting nowhere. Well, I want you to turn to the one next to you and tell them,
you tried your way, it didn't work, no. Put him second. And put you first.
Oh, yeah.
You trusted friends. Thought they had your back.
Oh.
And every time you turn around, it seems you're under attack. Yeah. But turn to your neighbor and say,
hey.
See, the devil is alive.
Hey.
No, I'm not gonna die.
Hey.
It's okay to cry,
because
he's by your side.
Hey.
You gotta stop that hating.
Hey.
I know you don't want to hear it.
Hey.
Gotta fast and pray and listen to the Spirit, because
I'm trying to tell you something.
He's speaking to your heart right now.
I'm trying to tell you something.
Just listen to the Spirit.
Oh.
Hold up.
Listen.
You lost your job.
Hallelujah.
Your bills are due. And all the people you help.
Praise the Lord.
Did not want to help you.
Praise the Lord. This is your host, Elder Gregory Newsom, with the Faith in God Internet TV. We want to say God bless you in the name of the Lord. Today is a blessed day. And so we count it a great blessing to be in the house of God. We do honor God who's ahead of our life, and to our honorable pastor and the person, Bishop Ellis Murchison Sr., to my own wife, Missionary Newsom, and to the household of faith, to the people of God, and to the listeners on the broadcast today. Let us go before his throne in a word of prayer. Let us keep on our hearts the prayer of the Murchison family. Let's pray for them. And let's pray for one another. Let's pray for the sick that's among us. Pray for our mothers. Let's pray for souls that God would touch and God would save. And we're praying that God would send spiritual healing to the body of believers, and that he would cause us to continue to grow stronger in him. And so let us pray one for another in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Eternal God, our Savior, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord, as we come before thee and before thy throne. Lord, we want to thank you, oh God, for your mercy and grace toward us. I want to thank you, Lord, for, oh God, saving us. I want to thank you for the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. We want to thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh God, for your goodness and mercy toward the people of God. Most of all, Lord, we want to thank you, Lord, for just being, oh God, God in our lives. Besides you, there is no other. And so, God, we give you homage. We give you praise. We give you adoration, because it belongs to you. And Father, as we pray now, we pray that you would touch the listeners on this broadcast. We pray now, God, that you would send healing, oh God, to your people. Look on, oh God, the Murchison family. We pray, God, you would continue to touch right now in the name of Jesus. Look on our pastor, Lord, First Lady, Lord. Look on, oh God, the Murchison family as a whole, God. Give them comfort and give them strength in the name of Jesus. And, oh, God, we pray, God, for the Murchison family. We pray for Deacon Murchison, Sister Murchison, Sister Janice. We pray, God, you would touch in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, look on their family now. Oh, God, move like only you can. Stretch forth, oh, God, your hand to heal in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we praise you. We decree and declare it done right now. Oh, God, and we praying, God, that the soul would be saved and delivered. Oh, God, and we claim a great deliverance even now in the matchless name of Jesus. And, Father, we forever thank you. We give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen and amen. And so we thank God for you, you and you today. I'm your host, Elder Gregory Newsom, with the Faith in God Internet TV. I want to say God bless you to all of our subscribers and listeners today. God bless you, Sister Marvella, Mother Flowers, and to all of our listeners today. If you want to log in to the Podbean Live to let me know that you're listening, please do so now. We're going to get right into the word of the Lord. We want to talk about a couple things on this week. One of the topics, we're just going to start out with the first one. The first topic we're going to talk about, that we are not to revile. We are not to revile. And we want to deal with the word revile or revelings. And praise God. And there's, as a people of God, we have a responsibility not to display our character and attitude as the world, because the word of God lets us know that we should be different. Amen. And when I say different, you know, sanctified means to be separated. Okay. So when we have been sanctified, that means we have been separated for the use of God. You know, Timothy talks about being sanctified for the master's use. And so when we're sanctified, we're set aside to be used by God. And so as a people of God, we don't want to find ourselves reviling or reviling. And we're going to get a few scriptures today. First scripture we want to get, I just want to lay the foundation here so that we can kind of get an understanding, you know, of what we are to do as a people of God. And so we don't want to be caught reviling and doing things that, you know, that God is not pleased with. And we're going to go to scripture, 1 John 2 and 15, where it says here, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. And it says, if any man love the world, says here, you know, if any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. And he goes a little bit farther here in 1 John 2 and 16. And he says, for all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And so when we act unseemly, or we begin to revel or revile, then we know that that's not of God, that's of the world. And so we, as a people of God, we want to make sure that, you know, to revile means to criticize. And I've in these last and evil days, we have seen more people of God murmur, complain, and criticize others. You know, when the scripture tells us in Psalms 1, you know, that blessed is the man, you know, that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, you know, nor standeth in the way of sinners, and nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. You know, and it says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doeth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth fruit in his season. His leaf shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Now, we got to examine, as a people of God, if we're not prospering, we have to do examination. And so as a people of God, we have to do examination and say, you know, am I being overcritical of a particular situation or circumstance in the church that I don't understand, or that I don't have revelation on from God, what I'm supposed to take from this. Because a lot of times the first thing we do is because our flesh wants to be hostile. You know, the flesh will hold you hostage if you don't die out to it, if you don't, you know, walk in it. You know, Romans 8 and 1 says, therefore now there is no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. And so the flesh wants to hold us hostage by having us do these things that's not pleasing to God, and that it does not edify, that it do not edify the body of Christ. And so to revile is to criticize in an abusive or hostile way. You get shortchanged by the teller or the cashier in the grocery store, and you giving reading them the riot act. That's not, you know, that's not becoming holiness. You know, that's, you know, the people of God should not act unseemly. And so if we're reviling, you know, we spreading negative information about someone, that's what revile means. The Bible says now, you know, we're going to get into it a little bit later, but we just want to start it out talking about the word revilings or to revile. Okay. So we're going to talk about these two meanings of these words this week, so we can get an understanding through the scripture, how we are to respond as a people of God. We are not to revile. We're going to go to Amos 6 and 7. We're also going to go to 1 Peter chapter 4, verse number 3 through 5. Okay? You can read 1 through 5, but I'm just want to start at 3 through 5. But I want you to focus in on, we are not to revile. Okay? And now I know sometimes your flesh feel like crying, you know, hollering out. And the only thing that's really affected is the flesh, because the spiritual man is not hurt. The flesh gets hurt and it wants to act out. Praise the Lord. And so we have to refrain from acting out. We have to bridle our tongue. We have to hold our peace and let the Lord fight our battle. Then victory shall be ours. And so we want to say that to the people of God, be encouraged today. We are not to revile. Okay. Even though we may have done it, the word of God teaches us and help us to understand we are not to be caught there. Once we know better, we do better. Okay. And so when we verbally attack someone by calling them and him or her a name, or we say mean things to people, this is an example of a time when you have reviled. Okay? And sometimes we don't know what revile mean. You know, sometimes we do things and we don't understand the meaning of it or the definition. And so when we look at the word revilings, it's found both in our King James Bible, and it's also in several other Bible definitions. But I want to give you, the point of what revile also has to deal with. Revile has to deal with orgistic or orgastic heathen worship. So that can be revilings, meaning it could be a group of people doing something that's illicit, okay? That's not right. Uncleanness, lasciviousness, which is the work of flesh, lust. And we can do what a lot of people do in church. They try to act as if these things don't exist, you know, amongst us, but they do. And they don't just exist in unbelievers, but they exist in the church. And we have to be taught not to revile. Praise the Lord. And so my bishop put it best. I agree with the point. You know, my bishop put it best. If you can't say nothing good about an individual, then just don't say nothing at all. Okay? Take that as a point of advice, you know, as a point of wisdom, a point of interest. If you don't have nothing good to say about the person, don't say nothing at all. You know, because some people, you come in the church, you may have a certain hat on or scarf, you know, or the women may have a certain shoe on, and or a brother may have a certain sport coat on, or, you know, or may have a certain tie on. And people, the first thing they want to do is criticize. You know, they don't realize that it's not the tie that they're really criticizing. It's the person they're really trying to criticize. And sometimes we do things ignorantly and we end up hurting people. And then we, once we find out that that was not our intentions, then now we got to find ourselves repenting and apologizing and trying to correct something that we did ignorantly. Now, there is a such thing as constructive criticism. And we need to know how to do that. We should never tear a person down unless we know and have the ability to instruct and build up. And so that's what we're learning. That's what I'm learning as a brother in Christ and as a servant. I'm learning that we need to put things in perspective, okay? And so we don't want to find ourselves reviling, you know, in the way that we're walking in our flesh. You know, it can mean being drunkenness, carousing. You know, sometimes we criticize by getting other people's opinion. Let me give you an example. Sometimes we say, that look ugly, don't it? Now, if it look ugly to me, I don't need to get your opinion on it. Praise the Lord. If something don't look right to me, I don't need to get five other people's opinion. I can just call it what it is. But what we do, we like to get a group of people involved that's not even involved in the situation. We'll call five other people and say, you know, that suit really looked ugly on them, didn't it? And my thing is, if it didn't look right to you, then that's a preference of yours. Don't try to suggest to five other people that it's ugly, because they may think it looked right. They may think it looked nice. And so these are the things that we deal with on a daily basis, not only in the church, but in the world. Okay. But I read 1 John 2:15. It tells us to love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. For all that's in the world is the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. Sometimes we find a way to find something wrong with something simply because we don't like it. It's not because it's something wrong with it. And so we have to make sure we're not reviling. You know, sometimes there's nothing wrong with, you know, a certain item that a person may have or may be using. But we'll find fault with it because we don't have it. You know, it's not in our possession. And that's where covetousness and lasciviousness and all these other, you know, works of the flesh. There's 17 works of the flesh that if we allow those things to start working in us can cause some problems. Okay. So I want to encourage you today through the word of the Lord. We are not to revile. Revile mean we can be rioting too. You know, we can get a group of people, and it's a difference between protest and riot. I try to explain that in an earlier broadcast about a month ago. There is a difference earlier this month. There's a difference between riot and protest. And, you know, when we get to rioting, saints and people of God, it's not supposed to be rioting. I can give you scripture on it. Go to Romans 13 and go to 13, Romans 13, and I think 13. Yeah, 13 and 13 through 15. We are not to revile. And so, you know, we do things and don't understand the meaning of it. You know, the word revelry simply means to banquet. Moses went up to talk to the Lord 40 days and 40 nights. Joshua stood down at the foot of the mountain. Okay. The people got anxious. The people got nervous. And they told the assistant pastor, we don't know what he left us out in this wilderness. We don't know what happened to Moses. You know what? You need to lead us now because he hadn't came back. We don't know if, you know, if he up there talking to, we don't, you know, people, all kinds of stuff go through people's mind when they begin to get anxious. And guess what? I'm paraphrasing now. That's not exactly what happened in the scripture, but this is a paraphrase of how people do. And they told the assistant pastor, you need to lead us. We need you to build us a God, build us a golden calf. Lord have mercy. And they began to have parties. And they began to have all kinds of banqueting. You know, it simply means to be excessive and boisterous, intemperance, lustful indulgence, meaning they were having themselves a good time with the flesh. And so we are not to be in revelry or revelings or to revile. And so we need to be careful as a people of God. We need to look at these meanings, look it up. You know, I deal with the scripture face value. Look up the script. Look up the word revile or revelings. Okay. Look them up. I'm giving you the definitions right now, but if you have questions about it, read it for yourself. Okay. And so reveling simply means to have a great time or to delight in something. Okay. You know, my thing is, you know, it's nothing wrong with, you know, having a celebratory setting. But when it gets to the point where it's out of control, you know, where there's no temperance, when you're drinking and partying and getting drunk, you know, saints don't, you know, people of God, you know, don't get drunk and get violent and break the law. And the police got to be called, okay? A violent disturbance of peace. That's what revealing deal with. And so we too, with this social injustice going on with, you know, the racial hate and disparity in our country, we cannot get in an uproar and riot and loot and tear down stuff and, you know, we just can't get involved in that stuff. Let me give you some synonyms to it. Uproar, rampage, fervor, tumult, tumultuous, upheaval, disturbance, street fight, you know, scuffle. We can't get involved in this stuff as a people of God. And neither should the people of God get caught in any type of reviling. Praise the Lord. And so we as a people of God, you know, and I look at things, you know, through the scripture, through the lens of the scripture. And I look at it as we as a people of God, the Bible says, you know, in Hosea 4:6, my people are destroyed because of a lack of knowledge. God bless you, Evangelist Lee and Sister Marvella, and to all of you that are listening. But Hosea 4:6 says, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. It's not because the knowledge was not provided, but it's because they rejected the knowledge. We cannot reject truth and expect to continue to walk, you know, on the right path with God. You know, David said, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. You know, the scripture in Psalms says, wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his ways? By taking heed thereunto the word of God. And so we too, as a people of God, we are not to revile. Take heed. We are not to revile. Okay. We're going to get these scriptures and we're going to get on out of here. Okay. So let's go to Psalms 1. We was in Psalms 1 and 1, and we read down to like verse 3, and it says, "And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth fruit in its season. His leaf shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper." Okay, let's read the next verse. If you're caught reviling, let's look at this. Verse number 4, Psalms chapter 1, verse number 4. He says, "The ungodly are not so." If you're reviling, you're putting yourself in a position to act in an ungodly manner. We as a people of God, we got to bring this flesh into subjection and bring this flesh under control. Praise the Lord. Temperance simply means to have self-control. Okay? "The ungodly are not so." Praise the Lord. "But are like the chaff, which the wind driveth away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous." Lord have mercy. "Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous." So if you're righteous, we should not revile. We should not get caught in doing what the ungodly do. If we're practicing what the ungodly do, that places us in ungodliness. Praise the Lord. Titus 2:11 says, "For the grace of God, which bringeth salvation, teaches us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, that we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world." Then we can look for the glorious appearing. Then we can look for this glorious appearing of the great God and Savior Jesus Christ. We can look for him then, but not until our life bear witness that we are the sons of God. Praise the Lord. So if you're claiming to be a son and a daughter of God, your actions should portray it as well. Don't say one thing and do another. We should live what we preach about. Okay? That's to the preacher as well as to the people of God. Too many times we want to tell people how to live, and then we don't live it ourselves. We don't want to be a modern-day scribe or Pharisee. We want to put it into action. James 1:22 tells us to be ye doers of the word and not hearers only. He says, "For the Lord," verse 6, "for the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish." Jesus told us that he had gave his life, according to St. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever should believe it in him should not perish." Why would God save you to call you to perish? God would not save us to cause us to perish. It's because we walk in ignorance of the scripture and we do things counterproductive, counterclockwise of what the Bible tells us to do. We are not to revile. Praise the Lord. As I said earlier, to revile means, for those of you that just came on my sidebar, you know, to revile simply means to criticize in an abusive or hostile way. It's nothing wrong with having a concern. It's nothing wrong with constructively criticizing or having an opinion about something. But when we verbally attack people, when we verbally attack and assault saints, verbally attack and assault one another, you need to examine that. Praise the Lord. And we should not call people names as people of God unless we're calling them by their first and last name. Praise the Lord. I hope I made myself clear today. We got more for you on this week. We're running out of time. But I want to say this to the people of God, and we should not say mean things to one another. We shouldn't say things to hurt one another. If we, you know, if we didn't mean to say it, don't say it. Praise the Lord. And a lot of time we say things and we have to take it back. Don't say it. This is just as a point of wisdom to you. We are not to revile. We're going to go to Amos 6 and 7. All right. So let's go to Amos chapter 6, verse number 7. It says, therefore, now they shall go captive with the first that go captive, and the banquet of them that stretch themselves shall be removed. We just read it in Psalms. The ungodly shall perish. And here in Amos, it said they were going to be removed. Praise the Lord. We want to be where God wants us to be, in total compliance of the scripture. We want to be in total compliance so we can be with one accord and we can walk in the unity of the spirit. We can, where there's unity, there's strength. So I want to encourage the people of God. I want to encourage you, for those of you that are out there listening to us, if you have revile, just repent. Just talk to the Lord in your prayer today. Just repent of it. Okay, it's just that simple. Just repent of it. Find yourself speaking positive. Find yourself speaking life. And remember what I said earlier in my sidebar. If you don't have anything good to say about an individual, practice not saying anything at all. When you practice that, you will find yourself growing to another level in God. And then you'll be able to see that God will begin to open up through revelation. He'll begin to anoint you and elevate you to a way where you can minister to other lives. You don't have to have a minister's license to minister. You can minister to people because you feel with the Holy Ghost. You can minister to people. But we only going to be able to do these things when we practice harmoniously, you know, the scripture, the teaching of the scripture. We got to walk in compliance to the scripture. Okay. He says, the Lord has sworn by himself, said the Lord God of hosts, I abhor the excellency of Jacob and his palaces. Therefore, I will deliver up the city with all that is therein. And so I want to say this to the people of God. We have to be careful. A lot of times, you know, Israel went into captivity, got into trouble with God because they did not adhere to his counsel. We as a people of God, we want to adhere to the counsel of God. According to Hosea 4 and 6, we don't want to reject knowledge. We don't want to be destroyed for the lack of knowledge. The lack of knowledge don't always mean that it's not being taught. You know, our church, we teach repentance, we teach forgiveness. But if people don't do it, it's because they're rejecting it. It's not that we don't teach the principles. Praise the Lord. And so we just want to make it clear today. We love you. We want to say God bless you to Mother Flowers, to our dear Evangelist Lee. Thank God you're back in town. Sister Marvella, to all the people of God. We want to say God bless you. We did have some more scriptures that we wanted to get. You can write down 1 John 2 and 15. That was another scripture that we had called. We'll pick it back up again tomorrow if the Lord's will. We are not to revile. We're going to go to 1 Peter chapter 4, verse number 3 through 5. You can read that in your study time. We went over the definitions and meaning. We'll go back over it again tomorrow as a point of review. But we're going to continue this series on this week. We are not to revile. And so we want to say to the people of God that we love you. Continue to pray for the Pentecostal Power Church family. In particular, pray for our Bishop, First Lady. Pray for the Murchison family, Deacon Cortez, Deacon Andrew Murchison in particular. Continue to pray that God will continue to stretch forth his hand to heal. I'm decreeing and declaring it already done by faith. We should, as a people of God, I understand we're in the flesh yet. Sometimes we get shaken. But we have to understand that we must walk by faith and not by sight. And we got to let our faith be put into motion. Amen. So I'm believing God for a report, a good report, a report. We're believing the report of the Lord. And so we're praying that the will of God be done. Now, whatever his will is, my prayer through wisdom is that we have the strength and the understanding and the wherewithal to accept the will of God. And so whatever God says, Lord, give us the strength to accept your will. But in the meantime, we're believing God. We're speaking life and we're claiming it done. And so we're saying what God told us to say, speak life. And so we're speaking life into that situation and we're believing God. And we have a great expectation because we know the Lord is able. And so we want to say God bless you today. We love all of you as a people of God. Please tune in tomorrow if the Lord's will, if you have time. Even if you don't, please view us later on. If you're busy, tied up, we're here. We'll be on video stream tomorrow at the 1 o'clock hour. We'll be on there at one to, you know, till about 1:30 there about right after the prayer that is had on tomorrow. And so we also will be on Bible class tomorrow night as well. And so just stay tuned to YouTube or Facebook where we'll be live streaming on tomorrow. And so with no further ado, we want to say God bless you. May God keep you. I want to thank you for listening to all the people of God. We want to say until next time, we want to say God bless you in Jesus' name. And just before we go, we want to say a word of prayer. Precious Father in heaven, in Jesus' name, Lord, we come before thy throne in the name of Jesus. Father, as we pray, we thank you. We praise you. We give you glory and honor. And because you are God and besides you, there is no other. We know you have our petition because you hear us. We pray, God, for the Murchison family. We say this special prayer for those that have special requests that's gone up before you. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would grant it, that you would honor it in the name of Jesus. You would grant the request of thy people in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we pray and pronounce, oh God, that your will would be done. As we give you thanks and praise, we pray, God, that you would send divine healing, send a spiritual healing to the body of believers. Look on, oh God, those that are not saved, those that are listening to this broadcast, oh God, touch and minister. Oh God, the family, oh God, that receive counsel, Lord. We pray, God, you would touch them now in the name of Jesus, Lord. You would send increase. Look on, oh God, the body of believers, send an increase of faith, oh God, to your people, Lord. Help us now, oh God, to not be moved, oh God, by what we see and what happens in our lives. But help us, oh God, to speak, oh God, the things which are not as though they were. And Lord, we speak healing and we declare a great deliverance in the name of Jesus. Look on Sister Janice Murchison, Lord. Look on the siblings. Look on our bishop. Oh God, look on, oh God, the Murchison family as a whole. Lord, continue to guide the hands of the doctors. Continue, oh God, to minister healing like only you can, Lord. Oh God, and we thank you for it, and we decree it done by faith. Oh God, look on those, oh God, that have doctor's appointments, oh God. On this week and this month, in the month of July, we pray, God, you would touch and minister healing. Go before thy people, Lord, and grant healing as we pray now. We believe that you will stretch forth your hand to heal in the name of Jesus. Look on Sister Grace right now. Father, touch in the name of Jesus. Look on, oh God, on our God daughter. We pray, God, for the Lee family. We pray, God, you would touch now in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch our daughter right now. Bless now in the name of Jesus. Send us spiritual healing, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, touch Grace now. And oh God, let all be well. And we believe your report and we decree and declare it. And we claim it done by faith. Oh, God, continue to bless Deacon Murchison in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We forever give you glory. We touch and agree now. We pray, God, for the souls that are on the altar yet tearing for the Holy Ghost. You would save them, God. You would grant them deliverance. Move by your power. We thank you and we praise you for it. And we claim, oh God, increase in the lives of, oh God, your people. We thank you and we praise you for it. Continue to look on the elderly, God. Yes, in our church and in our communities. Let your blood cover them, God. Keep them, Lord. Even though we see the numbers climbing, Lord, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Help us, God, to apply wisdom. Help us, God, in the name of Jesus. Help us, God, that we don't be found in contempt of what you're doing in our lives, but help us, God, to, oh God, apply wisdom, oh God, to this pandemic. Help us right now, oh God, that we continue to walk in faith. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, we trust in you, God. But while we're trusting you, God, we're doing what's necessary. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, that you might, oh God, give us immunity and protection of this virus. But help us, God, to put on our mask. Help us, God, to do what we need to do. Wash our hands. Help us, God, to use wisdom in this pandemic, that we don't charge you foolishly. But, oh God, help us, God, to apply wisdom, that we might declare your blessings to others. And, oh God, that we'll be able to lift you up and praise you. Oh God, help us now. Encourage us now. Take us through now. And help us to take this pandemic seriously. Even though we are people of God, help us to know, God, that, oh God, it rains on the just as well as the unjust. And there is no respecter of person with God. And Father, we thank you and we forever give you glory. And we give you all the honor and the praise. We claim healing and deliverance in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen and amen. Amen. God bless you. Amen. We want to say God bless you. God bless you in Jesus' name. We love all the people of God. Until next time, I'm your host, Elder Gregory Newsom, with the Faith in God Internet TV. God bless you in Jesus' name.